To get a sense of what life could be like after the pandemic, we look at Gibraltar. Now, the British territory on the Spanish coast is not even twice the size of New York's Central Park. And yet its health officials say nearly everyone there is now fully vaccinated against COVID. Well ahead of Israel, the US, or indeed the UK itself. And as a result, life pretty much heading back to normal. Look at them outside, enjoying the weather. Fabian Picardo is the Chief Minister of Gibraltar, and the Minister, Chief Minister, is with me now. Chief Minister, thank you. This is amazing, an achievement. Now, if you were to tell us what life is like now you have got to herd immunity, how is it?
Well, Richard, it is almost back to what we used to call normal. This is not an achievement of the government of Gibraltar on its own. It's an achievement of Her Majesty's government of the United Kingdom that has supported us by providing us the vaccine. We've been able to jab it into people's arms, you know, as quick as the clappers, as soon as we got it. And we have been able to see our people walking down our main street and going about their business without their masks, without the need for any social distancing to be enforced. I'll tell you a little anecdote. Just today, I met someone who I didn't know before the pandemic, who I had only ever known with a mask on, and I was able to see his face and see exactly what his smile looked like. So that's what the world has coming to it, as long as the vaccination programs are followed and as long as people accept that the vaccine is the way out and science is leading us out of the pandemic.
Sir, the tourist season's beginning. We know Greece is opening May the 17th. Spain, I assume, will do something similar. The significance for you is to get tourists during the summer season. Can you do it?
Well, we think we can. We think that with the United Kingdom opening up its travel corridors again after the 17th of May, we hope that the decision that is made by the United Kingdom government, it's a decision entirely for them, will be to see that Gibraltar is a safe place for UK tourists to come, UK travellers to come. People from the United Kingdom travel to Gibraltar not just for tourism, but also because of our cultural links and for business. And of course, we have an open frontier with Spain, and I hope that we'll be receiving a lot of international tourists who I sincerely hope will be able to come to Spain this year for the benefit of the Spanish economy and our economy too.
And are you worried about the next round of negotiations with Spain, with the EU, over the relationship? You have got an open border as a result of a last-minute deal at the end of last year, but now comes the big tough difficulties.
Well, I expect that the border will always be open between Gibraltar and the European Union, between Gibraltar and Spain. The question is whether we have a fluid frontier between Gibraltar and Spain and the European Union. And I'm very optimistic. I think the difficult balancing act had to be done in the context of the New Year's Eve agreement. The United Kingdom and Gibraltar on the one hand and Spain on the other came at those arrangements with goodwill. We were able to reach agreements that we think will work for the benefit of all of the people who live around Gibraltar and in Gibraltar too. I think we can create what González Laya, the Spanish foreign minister, rightly calls an area of shared prosperity. And I think the European Union Commission will want to form part of this historic resolution of many of the issues that have bedeviled our relationship in the past. And I'm very confident that that is the way that the Commission will want to structure its mandate and engage with the United Kingdom for these treaty negotiations to come.
Well, congratulations on herd immunity and returning life to something approaching normality. And Chief Minister, we look forward to bringing Questmean's business to Gibraltar, hopefully before not too long. Thank you, sir, for joining us.
I shall look forward to seeing you here.
That's fine. Find a decent restaurant and we'll be off to the races. Lovely. Thank you, sir. I'm sure there's plenty there. Now.